Thriller was released on December 1st, 1982. It was one of the great events in pop music history. It became the largest selling album ever, selling over 40 million copies. In 1983, it was selling an average of 1 million copies a week. It had 7 top 10 singles, 2 of which went to number 1. Beat It and Billie Jean. Thriller won 7 Grammys. The music video was an extraordinary event in its own right. It was a mini-movie and had a sensational home video release before going to MTV. Michael was the first black male artist to get playtime on the music television network. His music videos gave the genre a new distinction. He created a whole new art form. Bad was released in 1987. Michael toured for 18 months. The world couldn't get enough of him. Michael was now a superstar. The media and the fans followed him everywhere. Michael sought solace and privacy at his new home, Neverland Valley Ranch, on property he purchased in the Santa Ynez Valley in California in 1988. He built a home with its own amusement park and zoo and a railroad that circles the ranch. The boy who grew up with no Christmases and no birthdays and none of the normal childhood pleasures gave himself a wonderland in which he could indulge his inner child. His had been a childhood of hard work, struggle, and pain. My childhood was completely taken away from me, he said in a 1993 interview. It was the price he had to pay for his eventual professional success. Jackson has been married twice. The first time to Lisa Marie Presley, Elvis's daughter. The marriage lasted less than 2 years. He married Debbie Rowe in 1996. They have 2 children. In the 1990s, Jackson released 2 albums, Dangerous and History. Both times he went out on tour. Fans around the world, but not in the United States, were witness to some of pop music's most extravagant productions. Michael Jackson's story includes numbers that startle. Numbers about record sales, recording contracts, the purchase of the Beatles' catalogs, top 40 hits, number 1 hits, stadium crowds. Numbers about money being earned. But they do not include the numbers related to his good works, the millions of dollars he gives to charities each year, to his own nonprofit Heal the World. Numbers can't tell the whole story of his work with families and children around the world, or of his efforts to raise awareness about the environment. These stories can only be told by actions. In 1985, Michael co-wrote We Are the World with Lionel Richie. The song raised funds for the starving people in Ethiopia. We're saving our own lives. It's true, we make a better day, just you and me. Jackson's life has not been without controversy, from which he has never run away. He has answered his critics in major interviews, some on television. He's done it with dignity and without rancor, whether it's about his skin disease, his marriages, or his lifestyle. In the end, he lets his dancing and singing speak for him. I love to sing, he wrote. It's as natural to me as breathing. Michael has been accorded the Grammy Legend Award and is in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Nothing, he wrote, is more important than making people happy. Moonwalking, singing, spreading goodwill and joy with his music, Michael Jackson does indeed leave people happy.